Hello, so the game had a huge update. So in order to save time, I'll just link the change log into the comment section and I'll just tell you the short story of everything. So in about 2 or 3 minutes is the short story without any details, and then I'll just tell you all the details about, you know, the new changes. First of all, the most important change is the adventure mode, because yeah, adventure mode is launched. So what is adventure mode? Adventure mode is like a parallel campaign on a single planet. So go to all settings, this is your campaign, you don't need to mess with it. And then you have a new adventure. For example, you want to fight on Yaesha. Okay, no problem, choose your difficulty, create an adventure mode. See, now we have Yaesha. So you'll do this planet as normal, meaning you'll do all the bosses, all the dungeons and the world boss, and then you get to keep all the loot. And you can switch between them. See, this is teleport to the jungle, but if you want to return to your main campaign, which is awesome, this is exactly what I wanted, you can just go to all settings and select the other campaign. This also means that you can play, for example, campaign on normal and Yaesha on nightmare to get that forged iron. Other important updates were, for example, you don't use stamina when you're running in World 13. We have a new item, which is sold by Reggie. And now each armor set has a new trait. For example, this one has a slightly increased evasion window, but that's not a good example. Let's give a more clear example. The Twisted Wood set. Melee hits steal health from enemies. So now it has built-in melee lifesteal. Reload speed, it is increased by 10%. It's not very clear if the whole set will give you this bonus or it's just one armor piece. On the changelog it says that if you wear the whole set, you'll get the extra trait bonus, but I don't know, we'll just have to see. So yeah, each armor set has a new trait like this one. For example, another example will be the cultist hat. Mod power is generated slowly over time. So this is extra to the normal mod power you generate. That's great, right? Also, most of the weapons have been rebalanced. Some of them are really, really, really good now. Because, you know, they had to improve the weapons. As you can see, for example, the hunting rifle has 10% critical chance from 5, and the pistol has 15 from 5. Also, all the armors have an armor increase. For example, the Void Armor has about 50 or 60 armor increase. Flat bonus, exactly, because you know you start with a flat bonus when you're equipping the armor, and yeah, that adds a lot. So now you can have 800 armor with the Twisted Idol and of course the Divine Nectar, which means if you equip the two rings, this is the tank build. This is the tank build right now, the Void Skull, the Void set, and I'll just make another video about the tank set in tomorrow, I think. Now let's see, other than that they all have been rebalanced, and of course the crossbow and the bandit set has been reworked in such a way that it's no longer effective. I'll just mention more about this because this was the main complaint of a lot of people, the Devastator. So this will no longer trigger for each arrow individually for the same enemy. So if you hit 5 enemies, then you still get the chance to not use ammunition. The 35% chance to not use ammunition, but that means right now that you have to hit 5 enemies in order for the arrows to be have a chance to activate 5 times. So yeah, the more enemies you hit, the more chances you get to regenerate your ammo. So it's kind of bad because this was nerfed a lot. That means you can no longer get the more ammunition from, you know, shooting at a single enemy, which is great. And yeah, a lot of changes right now. A lot of changes to the soul anchor as well, so if you don't see it in our inventory, don't worry, it's bugged. They have actually managed to make our soul anchor disappear. This happened for a lot of people, but it's been reworked. So now you can only have max 2 of each minion, and each minion will give you 5% damage to your character, of course, if you are wearing the soul anchor. That means if you have 2 minions from one weapon and 2 minions from another weapon, that's a 20% extra damage increase. Which is a lot, but I have to get the Soul Anchor amulet again, which is extremely hard to do. Other than that, the changes from the armor, from the weapons, from the mods, the summoning mods. Oh yeah, the swarm is no longer bugged, so the bugs are no longer bugged. Which is a great news, because now the swarm ability is one of the strongest in the game. And I definitely recommend you try it out. You get it from the troll in Corsus. So Corsus is not in the adventure mode, so that means you have to re-roll the whole campaign if you don't have it. So now it will last the full 20 seconds. Hooray for us. Which means this is the most damaging mode in the game right now. Well, more or less. Now, you also have some changes with the Elder set, because I'll mention this because this is a very big change. So now when you use the heart, your allies will have increased damage. So 20% extra damage done by your allies if you use a heart. But this also means you can use the hearts anytime you want, see? So if you have full health with the Elder set, you can just use it to boost your allies' damage, which is an interesting way of doing it. Again, the Elder set is way more like a supportive tool right now. So I recommend you have a party with someone with Void Armor and someone with the Elder set. Now, other than that, this was the short version of all the things they changed. Now let's go to the long version of the changes, because I want to show you each of the changes. You can also modify the volume of the VoIP, voice over internet. Let's see, voice chat is enabled, voice chat, see, that's the voice, very important. Now, let's go for all the weapons. So what happened to the hunting rifle? What did they change? So the hunting rifle has now extra bullets in the magazine. As you can see, it's 10. It has a lot more capacity, meaning now it has 50 bullets as opposed to 45. So more bullets in the magazine and more bullets overall. And it actually has a 5% weak spot bonus damage. It doesn't show on the weapon itself, but it's in the patch notes, so it must be true. 5% extra damage to the weak spot, and also from 5 critical chance it's to 10. Which means some of the weapons will deal a lot more criticals right now. So yeah, the Radiant set is still viable with a lot of builds. Very good. Now the hunting pistol, as you can see, has 15% critical chance, which makes it again a very very good tool to deal a lot of critical damage. So critical damage is very good in this build, in this patch, or in this whatever you want to call it. Also the revolver, I don't know if it says right here, it doesn't say, but it has more staggering power. So 20% increase, no, 10% increased in impact damage. That means you'll stagger the enemies more easy with the revolver. Now the sniper rifle is another weapon that was hugely buffed. I think right now the sniper rifle is one of the best guns in the game. As you can see, it does a lot of damage, 220 at plus 10. But it also has a critical chance of 20. That means this is the highest critical chance in the game right now. Yeah, I don't know what to say about this. This could be very very dangerous with the all the traits and stuff, because you could basically critically hit a weak spot for, I don't want to say the numbers, but as you can see, the crossbow at plus 8 is 202, the sniper rifle at plus 10 is 220. It also has more ammunition. Hey, equip that thing. So yeah, if you want to be a sniper, now is the perfect time to be. Since it has 27 maximum ammunition, it reloads 10% faster, scope sway is reduced, as you can see it's very very easy to use right now. Also the initial reticle size is a lot smaller. See? This is actually usable without using the scope right now. Hey, don't be scared, I'm not shooting at you. Well, now I'm shooting at you. And some other things, but also, most of the weapons have a minimum crit range right now, so if the enemy is closer than 12 meters, you won't critically hit. So keep that in mind. I think this is also available for the hunting rifle and the hunting pistol. If the enemies are too close, you can no longer crit. Let's go to the next weapon, which will be the Chicago typewriter. This was actually, again, buffed very, very much. The first thing I saw when I opened the game and I saw it is that the minimum damage was actually buffed. So the initial damage was increased from 10 to 11. And now it's a lot more accurate. I don't want to go into all the details, but it's a little more accurate. When you move, it's basically the same. And as you can see, the spread is almost reduced to to accuracy after, let's say, 15 bullets. So yeah, it gets accurate even faster, so that makes it decent, but there is more to it. So it has, let's see, the decay speed has also been reduced, so if you fire like this and you have maximum accuracy, see, you need to fire only 5 bullets and it will get back to the maximum accuracy, which is great because now, again, the weapon is very effective. Now let's go to the particle accelerator, another weapon that was buffed very, very much in this build. Yeah, it got the same treatment as the sniper rifle. As you can see, it has the crit rage increased to 15 from 10, 15% just to critical hit. It does way more damage because, not way more damage, about 5 or 10 or 20 extra damage because mine is already upgraded. You can shoot it a lot faster right now. If you remember how this gun shot before, it was way slower than this, but now it's almost semi-auto. And of course the accuracy is still there. And yeah, you need to be in about... It's the same thing. If the enemy is closer than 8 meters, you won't critical hit with the gun. I think they should add this in the description of the gun, otherwise people will get very, very confused why they are not dealing critical hits. And also the gravity core is a lot better right now. Now let's go to the Devastator. It's a bit more accurate. It's way faster to reload, as you can see. So yeah, it has some debuffs, but it's actually been buffed, but it no longer works with the bandit set. The critical chance has been buffed to 10%, it reloads a lot faster. And yeah, if you hit one target with one arrow, that's one chance to hit to proc the bandit armor set. Otherwise, you need to hit 5 targets individually with the 5 arrows to have the same chances as before. Again, minimum crit range is 5 meters for the Devastator bow. Now let's go to the Defiler, because this is one of those weapons I never use. I don't know why, it's a pistol shotgun. Maybe that's why I'm not using it. So the idea range has been slightly increased, and the reticle was reduced, so it's a little more accurate. And the power requirement, it can fire the special ability or the alternative fire a lot faster. By the way, this shoots like a little star, as you can see. That's also a fun change. Now, as you can see, it has more range, which is great. Now the Defiler. Actually, I was talking about the Defiler, let's go to the Storm Rifle. Or the Eye of the Storm. Again, it has increased critical chance. And it also has a 5% extra weak spot bonus damage. It doesn't say here, but it is there. The range is still the same, but this is basically the same, it's just it has a higher critical chance. This is still not enough to make the weapon viable. Hive cannon projectile. It's a little better, nothing to commentate there. Now let's go on to the... Oh, this one is a beautiful thing. You know, the tentacles, now if you use the tentacles, they actually have life leech incorporated. So you no longer need to use the ring. The life leech ring. So if you have any other ring except that one and you use a tentacle, now it has base life steal. So yeah, that means each tentacle will heal you no matter what equipment you are wearing. And another big change was done to the spore bloom, which again is amazing. This does way, way more damage, I think. I mean, I never use it. All out. So I can't really confirm, so the damage was increased from 160 to 200. That means an extra 40 damage, you fire more pellets right now, and the range was increased a bit. Ideal range is now 10 meters from 8 meters. Also, I think it reloads faster. Yeah, it reloads faster. So let's 1, 2. It reloads faster and it's overall a lot better. This is kind of like the maximum damage weapon you have in the game right now. Beautiful. Now let's go and see what the new item is. Because that's also another thing we have to do. I only mentioned that. But this item you can buy, I think, from the beginning of the game.
Distance. She's got a other world. Let's see what we got.
So the Ring of the Admiral, 500 increased in the damage you take, and range and melee damage is increased by 15%. To scrap.
Safest of travels.
So what does this mean? What is this ring good for? Well, this is good for normal and for nightmare mode, of course. Otherwise it will kill you very, very fast. On nightmare mode, I think you receive already extra 300% damage, so this will kill you in one hit. It also, it's good for the boss fights that you, well, basically already die from one hit, so it's not such a big difference. But yeah, you definitely need to keep an eye out on this thing. Literally impossible. Oh, this will be so much fun. So remember, if you are playing with a friend, make him tank and you can use the Ring of the Admiral. Just don't get hit. Cleansing Jewel. Yeah, this is actually good because it removes all the status effect from your friends as well. When you use it with the Elder set, Lich Chamber. Yeah, the amount of life you leech with the Lich Chamber right now has been reduced. Just because it has been increased in the Twisted Armor set, which has a default life leech. Yeah, the Soul Anchor, as I said, it adds 5% extra damage to you per minion, and it also increases the duration of the summons by 50%. But you no longer get the additional, you know, the additional, the additional minion charge. So that means you have maximum two tentacles and maximum two of the other minions. Maximum two sentinels, two skulls, and so on. Okay, now let's go over each of the armor and see their, you know, what they changed. It will only be a quick show because I don't want to stay too long on the video. And you can just read if you don't want to listen to my voice. But yeah, increases movement, firing, melee, reload, and evasion. For 7 seconds and critical chance by 50%. Opportunistic. Perfect dodging enemies, bandit set. You get more ammo, increased ammo pickup by 25%. I'm only saying the extra stuff. Cultist head, slowly generate mod power over time. Drifter mask. When aiming and standing, movement speed is increased by 25%. So that means you can move and aim a lot faster. That means you are faster overall with the armor, which is pretty good. Again, your allies get increased damage when you're wearing the Elder set, which is a must-have set for co-op players. Sharpshooter increases weak spot damage by an extra 15%. And the other bonus is still the same. Osseous armor. This has probably the better trait of all of them. Melee speed and fire rate is increased by 5%. And also the bloodlust has been changed. So if you deal ranged or melee hits against the same target, you get increased damage on the target. So that means this is actually usable with all the builds right now. It would actually be better than the Void Armor, but the Void Armor has a lot more armor right now. If you want to compare the helmets and such, yeah, it's such a big difference. 141 armor for the voice call, 220 for the maximum level. But the Duster only has 100 and... So yeah, the changes are pretty good. I like them. Now, the Radiant Visage recoil is reduced by 10%. Scrapper set. You have increased your stagger damage by 20% if the enemy is in the range of your 5 meters. Reload speed is increased by 10% for the Slayer set, and also the Twisted Wood set is heavy right now. It's heavy armor, it's no longer medium. So a lot of people are complaining about this, and I don't know, what can I say? I've always been using the Void Armor, so I've always been using a heavy armor set. So this doesn't bother me too much, but yeah, the Twisted Wood set is now, of course, heavy armor. And it doesn't really have all the armor that you get with the Void set. See, the difference is so big right now. But yeah, play the tank, save your team. And I think that was about it, right? The twisted set, the twisted mask is still the same. Let me check some of the other things. Explosive shot was also buffed, so if you have explosive shot and use it, it's pretty good. And the Wasteland good boy has been buffed from good boy to very good boy. Yeah, that was a strong one. Again, this changes the whole meta of the game, making the sets more powerful, the weapons more powerful. You have a new ring, Soul Anchor is a lot better right now. We'll just have to see the rest. Okay, see you next time. Bye.